Dear Jacqueline, you must know how hard it is to bounce back from a relationship that has gone sour. But I found out the best way to get over an old love is to find a new one. Sometimes it's as easy as just opening your eyes.
Is there something else I can help you with?
Actually, you can.
What do you think you're doing? Eric.
Exactly what you want. Exactly what I want.
Tattoo, Eric.
like to join us, Eric? Go for it. I don't believe in wasting time. Especially when I'm as certain about something as I am about you making love to me right here, right now.
Innocence. I think your clothes are done.
Thank you.
Oh, that feels really good.
You need to relax and don't worry so much.
Well, sometimes I just get so frustrated.
Yeah.
Well, you're a woman. You know what it's like. What is it? Men just... they just don't get it, do they?
Relax.
I always wondered what it would be like with another woman.
Like a hot shower and a clean apartment.
Sam told me that you're interested in making a film.
Oh, yes. This is a dream of mine.
What kind?
Probably erotica. Most of my stories are erotic.
You know, I was looking forward to seeing this film.
I'll show it to you Saturday.
So you haven't noticed me coming in every week?
Well, yes. Of course I have.
Your girlfriend has noticed me too. See the window there? I have seen her. So what does she say about me? Does she think about me when you are making love?
Yes.
Did you imagine me there while you're making love?
Yes.
Yeah. So does it turn you on to see us together?
Oh my God, I guess there is no hope for this. The boss is really gonna wonder. Well, it's just an old friend, though.
I want you to do something for me.
Oh, you're not gonna blackmail me, are you?
No, hardly. I want you to make a movie for me.
What kind of movie?
Your kind. Erotica. It's for my husband. It's his birthday.
I made a terrible mistake after I married Dario. My life as a cellist with the symphony orchestra disappeared. And the demands of life as the wife of a successful businessman had emerged.
Yes, this could be for the
It's not even blue. It's purple.
Thank you, Aggie.
Dear Jacqueline, I don't know if you receive a lot of gifts with your letters, but please accept this as a symbol of my newfound belief in the undeniable spirit of Christmas. I was the guy who would do anything to get ahead. I wanted to work late every night, and even Christmas Eve. But then my girlfriend, or actually a few girlfriends of mine, set me straight.
Dear Jacqueline, my wife and I have both cheated on each other once. It was a few years ago when she was traveling a lot for a career. We had just moved into our new loft in Los Angeles.
Thank you.
get for you? How about a 7 and 7?
Sure. Okay. Is there a dancer by the name of Flame here tonight?
Flame? She's right in front of you.
$1,000?
I think that's a fair price.
$500.
$800.
$600.
Nope. $8.
Okay. $800. This better be good.
Yeah.
It was Thursday, May 9th. We were working a day watch out of Burglary Auto Theft Division. My partner is Ned Nelson. My name is Frank Timmons. I'm a cop. As you could tell, my partner is a female. This never presented a problem for us until one day. A burglary had been reported in a fancy resort hotel, the Escalier. The victim, Mona Reardon, just down from Santa Barbara on business. She was robbed of a $20,000 diamond necklace.
I'm sorry, Miss Reardon, but I don't think I'm going to be able to accommodate some of these requests.
Why not?
Well, especially, especially this one,
all you have to do is...
Dear Jacqueline, by day, I'd lead the life of a boring numbers cruncher. I make a pretty good living and have a fairly active social life, but I've always wanted to write the great American novel. Problem was, I never found the time, and I never knew what to write about. Well, that all recently changed, and my life hasn't been the same since. To think, it all started with a bowl of strawberries.
Dear Jacqueline, I just love to get the upper hand. No matter what the situation, I always seem to take control. And I've got to tell you, it's a great attitude to have, especially when you're looking for a little fun.
Could I buy you a drink?
Sure, but only if you'll dance with me. I've been dying to dance all night.
Excellent. I'm Pete.
Pete, Monica. Dancer, Pete. Got any other rhythmic grooves I should know about?
That's definitely possible.
It looks like I've definitely got your attention, little Petey.
Yeah, you definitely have that. But there's nothing little about Pete.
I need some fresh air. It's getting pretty hot in here.
Don't mention it.
Dear Jacqueline, I never dreamed that I would have anything to write to you about. But the most incredible experience happened to me last week. I can hardly believe it was real. It all started when I was in Boston for a conference. I got to my hotel room and found a wallet under the chair. As a general rule, conferences are pretty dull in my business. But this one was definitely a learning experience.
Dear Jacqueline, I've been working at a mailroom at Fantasy, an erotic magazine, for 3 weeks. It sounds like a dream job, I know, surrounded by beautiful women all day. But, unfortunately, the woman I'm in love with, Lily Gray, doesn't work in the mailroom. It was only recently that I discovered the real perks of the job.
Dear Jacqueline, I've recently found the courage to make my wildest dreams come true, and you won't believe how.
Thank you.
Nice place, Skippy.
You like it?
I do. Check it.
Be a little more comfortable with some of these on the bed.
Thank you.
You like them?
Mm-hmm.
Jacqueline, this experience taught me what I should have known all along. Never judge a book by its cover.
Love has just begun.
My little surprise brought out a sensual part of me I never knew existed. I don't know what I'll do next year to beat that present, but when I figure it out, I'll write you.
Dear Jacqueline, well, I finally found a gallery to show my photographs. The opening night of my show, I was so nervous. I decided to keep myself busy by staying in the darkroom printing.
We just sort of played. Went with the flow. Whatever happened, happened.
Fling your hair in your face. That's it.
You're so fun!
Down, down. Let's lose the chair. And the clothes.
Dear Jacqueline, after so many business trips, traveling has become a bore. My job, unfortunately, doesn't expose me to the most exciting people. I'm a scientist. But this last trip was one that got me excited about my job again. And at the same time, opened my mind to new sexual experiences.
You're sweet, Dr. Almond.
Oh.
Do you like that?
That turned you on.
Yeah?
Turned me on. You turned me on.
And you, baby, you turned me on.
You're driving me crazy. I was thinking about you and the doctor.
Now let's talk about you.
Are you turned on when you know a stranger's watching you? Do you often ask strangers to kiss you?
You were incredible, but you have to go now.
Oh, Miss Missy, you drive me crazy.
Discreet?
Very.
I'll see you tomorrow.
We agreed I should write because our arrangement would interest you. I wish I could tell you the actress's real name, but the deal isn't over yet. We still have a week left of shooting, and I love going to work.
Dear Martin, I got your picture in your letter. Seeing you really turned me on. Now I can imagine your face. Today I had an incredible fantasy about you.
Let me out.
Why should I?
Because I want to touch you without these bars in the way.
Oh, yeah. That could get me in trouble.
I'll show you trouble.
Oh, yeah. Do you like doing this?
I love doing this.
That's it.
Yeah. Harder. Harder.
Dear Jacqueline, Ian and I have been seeing each other for the past 3 years.
and we moved in together last summer. It was getting more serious all of the time, but both of us had concerns about marriage.
I'm gonna miss you.
Me too.
How much?
This much.
Oh.
Snow. That was amazing.
You're amazing.
You've been dreaming about this all of your life, haven't you?
Yeah.
Well, then get your butt over here and ask questions later.
Really?
Jacqueline, I'm a grad student
paying my way by working two jobs while going to school full time. It's exhausting, but I'm going to get my master's in the psychology of human behavior if it kills me. I tutor by day, and what I do at night, I consider on-the-job training.
Duncan.
Earth to Duncan.
Sorry, my mind tends to slip off sometimes.
We'll be right back.
tired, huh?
I'm dead on my feet.
Probably too tired to even stand up.
Just really wiped out.
So wiped? You're even too tired for this?
Thank you for spoiling me.
Yeah, it looks so good.
No.
Yeah. Turn it.
You look great.
This is what they do. heart's about to break. Boy, you made a big mistake. Make up your mind right now. Gonna have to make a choice somehow. Oh, please don't hesitate. You'll find out it'll be too late.
You told me you had no luck finding a place to stay last night.
Busted.
Mm-hmm.
I was commenting on the fact that they were able to find me a cabin, and it would have been the worst luck in the world to have to leave. So, Jacqueline, a trip that began as a disaster became one of the most important weekends of my life. Jamie and I are married now, and we both work so much we never see each other at home, but once a month we meet in an exotic location for what I like to call quality time. It may not be that often, but it seems to be often enough. We're expecting a baby. Thank God I didn't cancel that ski trip.